Former President Donald Trump is in court today, the first former president to ever face a criminal trial.
Fox 5 legal expert Wendy Patrick is here to break down this historic case. Wendy, good morning. Always good to see you.
Good morning.
With all that is surrounding this, sometimes it's hard to keep track on what's happening on which day. So what is this particular case that's starting today?
This is the first case that was indicted. This is the case that was initiated March of 2023. This is the hush money trial, not a trial that involves events surrounding this election or the 2020 election, but the 2016 election. So we're going back all of that time. Remember the allegations here. And this really shocked the nation when it happened, when Alvin Bragg, the DA in Manhattan, actually announced that charges were filed. Now, of course, fast forward now, he's got four criminal cases that are pending. This is the least serious of the four.
Oh, wow.
Nonetheless, it is significant that it's the very first time a former president has ever gone on criminal trial. And jury selection is going to start today. This is about 34 counts of falsifying business records surrounding the payments that Michael Cohen, who's likely to be the star witness, made to Stormy Daniels. This is about killing the story, the catch and kills, the National Enquirer scandal. Now, I have to refresh everybody's memory because so much has happened since then. But it is significant that this trial will both start and complete, no doubt, before the November election.
Jury selection has got to be a doozy for something like this, because usually you want somebody who hasn't heard of the case, hasn't heard of the defendant. How do you get the proper jury for a trial like this, given the fact that it is Donald Trump? Part of the questioning was like, well, have you ever, do you follow on Truth Social? Do you do all this other stuff? How do they pick a jury?
Yeah, good luck. That's that's one of the issues, and it's also a very unfriendly jurisdiction for the former president. Manhattan is not likely to have a lot of conservative voters. And you can't just ask people what their party affiliation is. In fact, that's one of the things they cannot ask. Mm. So you have to learn it circumstantially. Where do you get your news? What kind of job do you have? What do you feel about law enforcement? You have to sort of look at those surrounding issues, really the subtleties, and both sides are going to deselect jurors that they don't believe are going to be able to be fair to their respective sides. Having said all of that, it is still going to be challenging to get a unanimous panel. And that's partially because of the nature of the charges. You know, this isn't the case about initiating an insurrection. It's not a case about keeping documents. It's not one of the highly publicized cases we've heard so much about over the course of the last year or so since the indictments were announced. So it is going to be difficult. And remember, Raul and Shali, it's going to be about a two-month trial. This is not going to wrap up anytime soon. In fact, jury selection is not going to wrap up anytime soon. So, you know, you talk about sporting events and concerts, as I know you like to do. I follow you on social media. This is going to be exciting in and of itself, except it is so serious.
We'll talk more about how he's going to balance all of that, being in the courtroom while he's also on the campaign trail. But you just had mentioned about, you know, the area of New York, which is probably why it was denied for him to even move the case, because they did try to get this out of New York.
Yes, they did. And in fact, they'd love to move it to Florida because that's a much kinder jury pool. But you can't have all these change of venues without a good reason. And that's one of the reasons that this is continually being brought up, this change of venue. But, you know, I mean, you could move this trial to the moon and you wouldn't be able to get people that haven't heard about Donald Trump and all of the issues that surround him wherever he goes. And that's really the long and the short of it, is can you say that there's any other jurisdiction where there is a better chance? Maybe there's a slightly better chance, but that's not in and of itself a reason to move the trial.
Okay,
it's going to be in Manhattan.
So here's what I want to know. You mentioned this trial could take a couple months. That puts us in June when we get a... What would a potential conviction mean for his campaign? There was a rally over the weekend. They asked Trump supporters if he's found guilty, will that change? And they kind of scoffed at it, like, that's not even a real anything, it's nothing. And then he goes out and says, I've done nothing wrong, this is all. What will a conviction mean here, if anything?
Right, and that's exactly the question, is it might not mean much. Now, how do we know that? First of all, it's going to be under appeal by the time we get to November. Wow. So it's not going to be final anyway, at least in terms of some of the voters. But we also have to think about a conviction for what? Now, it is true, you need wrongful intent. Sure. It's not just a bookkeeping case, as I've heard some people call it. You need wrongful intent, mischaracterizing payments. But there are also people that remember the John Edwards case, where the defense defense was, I wanted to keep this affair from my wife because she was dying of cancer. Now, of course, Donald Trump denies the affair to begin with, so the facts are a little bit different. But are they? To the larger juror
pool, and that sunk John Edwards' campaign.
And it was, it's true, but it was also a not guilty verdict. And so when you think of some of what's going on here, you might also think, you know, are you likely to be able to get a conviction when there's such nuance to the charges? Wow. I don't know. And can you get all 12 jurors? Remember, they're selecting 12 jurors and 6 alternates. Can you get all 12 jurors to agree that he's guilty on all 34 counts? So there's a lot going on. I'm sure it's starting today, but it's not going to finish anytime soon.
No, it's not going to finish, but let's just like back up like 1 second before we even get to the conviction and the end of this. How is he going to balance this over the next few weeks? Because from what I understand, he's required to be in court.
That's right. Well, unless he's excused, yes.
But multiple days a week. At the same time, you know, you're running into the election. So how do you do all of that?
He said he's going to campaign at night, but we know because of his other appearances in those civil cases where he went to court when he wasn't even required to be there, that he's courtroom campaigning. We'll just coin that term. It's a courtroom campaign because he's using part of his argument to fundraise off of basically saying, I'm being targeted by being forced to be both a candidate and a litigant. And it has worked
so far.
It has been working so far.
It's working. He can do no wrong.
So there's your answer.
He's going to testify, too. So.
He says he's going to testify, but you know
what?
You
don't think so?
You wonder whether or not by the time we get to that point, his lawyers are going to talk him out of taking the stand. And that's partially because the main witness, Michael Cohen, sure, he's compromised, but that goes to his credibility.
Credibility and compromise is a whole thing. Okay.
Compromise.
Listen.
That's right.
Wendy Patrick, wow. Okay, thank you.
We'll talk again about this, no doubt.
Indeed, we will. Thank you so much. Coming